sermon is not a question. The Lord is my father, my father. He makes me not to death and bring justice. He leads me besides their waters. He restores my soul. He leads me to make justice for his name's sake. Even though I walk through the valley of the shadow of death, I fear no evil, for you are with me. Your rod and your staff will comfort me. You prepare a table before me in the presence of my enemies. You anoint my head with oil, my cup overflows. Surely goodness and mercy shall follow me all the days of my life, and I shall dwell in the house of the Lord forever. Let us pray. Gentle God, you shepherd us through the times of trouble. When the way seems dark, you guide us safely through. When we cannot bear to slow down, you show us the wisdom of Sabbath rest. In your presence, there is life overflowing, abundant, and free. We rest in your goodness. Teach us, O Lord, to see that your heart. Open our eyes to the word of becoming our neighborhood and to your beloved children, those needed to us today. Open our hearts to the blessed child here in your creation, which sustains us and yet is more powerful than we imagine. Anoint us with your spirit of blessing, that we might be as Christ to one another. Our room this morning is number 387, Savior, Life, and Shepherd, Jesus. Please stand and join us. So often when we think of doing things,
We see the same with moral truth, moral heroes, principles, and sorcerers, and sexual. If we think that sickness can be disconnected from which openly the God of the world, to the mass of being the truth about our friends, we realize that much of our sin is actually moral or socially acceptable. Let us confess those things before God and before each other. Join me in the prayer. Eternal and loving Father, you are the support and encourage us. Your goodness and kindness are very strong. Your grace is richer and deeper than your sin and goodness comes to heaven. Yet despite your gracious love and faithful care, you seem to go a long way and to trust that some resources come at the time when things are pointing over your will. Closing over again, our pride, self-reliance, and self-centeredness lead us astray. We confess we are sinners in need of forgiveness. We admit we are flawed, broken people in need of mercy. Through the person and work of Jesus Christ, forgive us for all the times that we have failed you. Cleanse our hearts and make them fresh and new. You are mine for your kingdom's sake. Empower us to be your son's disciples for his glory. We pray through Jesus Christ our Lord, through the power of the Holy Spirit. Amen. Your son is of heaven. Brothers and sisters in Christ, hear these words that you are in heaven. Ask and it will be given to you. Search and you will find me. Knock and the door will be opened to you. Know that God longs to hear our prayer. And long to communicate back. Friends, believe the good news of the gospel. Through Jesus Christ, we are forgiven. Let us live as He has forgiven you.
joining me this week. Holy God, whose word is a light to our path, illumine our hearts and minds by the power of your Holy Spirit. In the reading and proclamation of your scripture, confront us in our sin, comfort us in our sorrow, heal our wounds, and inspire us to follow you through the sake of Christ and Christ. Today, our first scripture lesson is from 1 Thessalonians 4, 1 to 7. Finally, brothers and sisters, we ask and urge you, the Lord Jesus Christ, to learn from us how God lived in his life. After that, to our belief, you should do so more and more. For you know what instructions we gave you through the Lord Jesus. For this is the will of God, your sanctification, that you abstain from fornication, that each of you know how to control your own body in holiness and honor, not with lust or passion like the Gentiles who do not know that. But no one wrongs or exploits your brother or sister in this manner, because the Lord is an avenger in all these things, just as we have already told you beforehand and solemnly warned you now. For God did not call us to impurity, but in holiness. Therefore, whoever rejects this, rejects not human purity, but God, who also gives the Holy Spirit to you. The word of the Lord. Thanks be to God.
I lift up my eyes into the hills, and whence cometh my help? My help cometh from the Lord, which made heaven and earth. He will not suffer thy foot to be moved, neither to the deep nor to the mountains. Behold, he that keepeth his foot shall neither slumber nor sleep. The Lord is thy keeper, and the Lord is thy sustainer. The Lord shall preserve thee from all evil. He shall preserve thy soul. The Lord shall preserve thy body from all evil. He shall preserve thy I'm going to go to the next one.
Thank you.
prayers to these troubled people. Now, the praise prayer is he's able to forgive us all of our sins, he says. Father, forgive them, for they know not what they do. Place where all of us the place where I can always say, this is where I know that God loves me, because this is where he gave his son. I know the truth of God me because he is fight for me. truth of Christ. He is the thank you. Thank you.